What's going on, you guys? How are you guys out there today? I hope that you're well wherever you are. It is the 4th of November 2022 and it's 11:26 p.m. I was almost like about to fall asleep and I said, "What is going on? I have to do a video on Ophiuchus and me." So, welcome guys to Ophiuchus and me. I appreciate you guys for being here with me. Let me turn my music down and let's get started. Like I said, I hope and I pray that you guys are doing well wherever you are on this wonderful Friday. And you know, some of you guys are probably out and about hanging with your friends and having a good time. And I just pray that you guys are all well and being safe wherever you are. And yeah, today was a very chill day at work. Today it wasn't hectic at all and I was very excited about that. The past 2 days we had some really interesting reads and you watering your garden and being able to refocus and rejuvenate and realign yourself. And also love was in the picture, and so that's great. And whoever that read was for, like I said, congratulations. So let's dive right in. And if you've never been here before, thank you very much. Also, all of you guys that have been here before and that have subscribed, that have liked, that have shared, that have just watched, I appreciate you guys for coming back. So I hope all of you guys like, I hope all of you stay, I hope you enjoy, I hope you come back. So, oh wow, who is that? As soon as I get started, then someone went, okay, it's not a text message, just an email, some random email. So, let's do a Sacred Destiny Oracle today, this evening, and also, this is such a beautiful card at the bottom, I can't help but show you. And it says, here we go, with you not being able to see. Let me turn my screen down again a little bit so you can see. I am adamant that you guys should be able to see the words. And I'm not just saying stuff. Okay, so it said, I don't like the angle of that. Stuff gets on my nerves, you guys. Forgive me. I'm just a little, okay, here you go. Thriving. You see that energy coming out of the tree? It's life, right? So pretty. Thriving. So I'm gonna use that deck, okay? Gonna take it up a notch. I was thinking of a song like not that long ago. Okay. Alright, so here we go. Like I said, if you've never been here before, I do an oracle deck, I do a couple index cards, and I do 3 tarot decks, so I can try to like see what's going on, see what's up, see what I see. So I appreciate you for rocking here with me today. And let's get this party started. Let's see what's going on today. And let's see what I picked up. Okay. One more time. I was really about to go to sleep, you guys. Like, I was over, like, at my other desk where I do my other videos, and I was reading my Bible, and I was pausing, like, just thinking about things. And we've had this particular card before, so I'm gonna put it back, but I'll show it. So adventures, you know, like waterfalls and different places and islands and all these great things and great places and things that a lot of you guys are experiencing. That's what I was looking for. You know, acquiring new levels and experiences. So, yeah, he just said the highest of the highs, exactly. Different levels, different things, new places. So, let's see what we have. All right. We have courage at the bottom. And so if I get the card, like, I'm not gonna take it. Like, yesterday I only took the card again because it came out back to back, okay? But like, I haven't used all the cards in there, so it's like, okay, like, I know I've gotten that card of interest with you guys, so I just showed it to you. And, you know, let's get a different card. Let's pick up some different type of energy. So, let's go. I have the word here on this card, flexibility. So, it's a tiger. There. Okay, so it says bamboo and wind. The symbolism of bamboo runs deep, whereas many larger, seemingly stronger trees will break in high winds. Bamboo simply bends and sways. Its flexibility allows it to survive and even thrive while other species suffer, even during a hard winter when its branches are laden with snow. It's always something. Like, my hair is making my shoulder trip out. Okay. Oh my gosh, what is that? I have the heater on too. Like, God, it's making my skin feel all like through this jacket material. I don't like certain. I felt like something was like crawling. I don't like stuff making my skin all like itchy. Okay, sorry about that. So anyway, it says here, even during a hard winter when its branches are laden with snow, bamboo doesn't break. It snaps back when the snow melts in the spring. Okay. I had to turn the page that time when I put it down. Sorry. It also has a strong root system so that even during great storms, it survives. Additionally, it is often a symbol of abundance because of its rapid growth. Excuse me. Its upward, verdant, constant growth is used as a metaphor for the fulfilling rise of prosperity. So, this sacred landscape wants you to know the meaning of this card is rich and varied. It cautions you to be flexible in your life. Be willing to bend and yield. There are times to stand strong, but there are also times to go around a situation rather than face it head on. This card suggests being amiable amenable. Oh my gosh, to change, what is that word? Lord have mercy. Telling you, I get these oracles and things, and I'm like, what does that say? Some words I look up and some words I don't. Now this word I have never. My God, amenable.
Amenable.
Amenable. Okay. It means open and responsive to suggestions, easily persuaded or controlled. Okay, so this card suggests being open and responsive to suggestions, to change. Amenable.
Amenable.
Okay, guys. So, open to suggestions, to change. It is also a fantastic card for abundance and prosperity, and it suggests that if you are flexible, prosperity can and will come your way in all areas. Additionally, it suggests that a time of rapid growth is ahead. Don't resist it. The time is right for this surge of spiritual growth to occur. Interesting. And so the card at the bottom, remember, was thriving. And then right before I put the cards away, at the bottom it said courage. So take the courage to be amenable and to take suggestion. Okay, or be open to or responsive to suggestions. Okay, but it also said easily persuaded or controlled. So that we're not going to take that particular end of what it could mean also. Okay. You know, that's interesting that they put that there like that, because just because you're open or responsive to a suggestion doesn't mean that you can be easily persuaded or controlled at the same time. It just means that you're open to it, but it doesn't mean that you're necessarily naive and gullible. You see what I'm saying? So sometimes you have to really kind of dig and find the right words that you want to use, I mean, and know exactly how you're using it also. But anyway, amenable. You learn something new every day. I don't never stop learning, and I love looking stuff up because I'm like, what the heck does that mean? So anyway, guys, let's continue. So be flexible and know that change is good. You don't always have to deal with things right away. Maybe not in the way or the approach that you would. Maybe take someone else's suggestion. Like, how would you deal with this? Like, what's going on? And know that your life is still changing and merging and into something much greater. Wait, what was the last sentence on that? Hold on one second. Yeah, the time is right for this surge of spiritual growth. Right. Prosperity, abundance, right? Rapid growth. So there may be some things that are coming your way. Maybe some personal situations that you may need some help with. Or not even necessarily help, but just a suggestion. Or, you know, like, you remember someone else going through something similar, and you're like, how did you get through that, you know? Or, you know, like, I remember you were struggling, like, you don't mind sharing, like, what all do you think that was about? Or, you know, just, I don't know, it's different for each person, you know, and the things that you may be feeling or going through, or, you know, if you feel that you can't get that answer from within and pray and find it. You know, someone else may have a suggestion for you. So be flexible and know that you always don't have to deal with things like right away. in the manner that you think that you may have to, or that you are used to dealing with things in, you know. So I'm about to get a couple of index cards, and then after that I'm going to get the tarot decks going. So if you're still here with me, I appreciate you. I'm a little tired, I'm not gonna lie. I already told you guys I was about to fall asleep. And let's see what we get today. That card came out, I believe, yesterday or the day before. So there are definitely some of you that are experiencing some great, yes, prosperity, and things that are coming around and changing your world, and because you're focused and you've been on the road for some time, going through challenges and so on and so forth. Do this one more time. Okay. So, this was there last night. I think it was last night. Go dancing. Alright. So some of you guys, you know, you may have a lot of different life type situations, and a lot of our growth. I was talking to one of my family members earlier about this, like, you know, the tests that we go through in life, really, a lot of them do happen when, you know, with people that we're close to, and it's very unfortunate, but it's the truth. And when you learn how to balance your emotions and take in all of what is being thrown at you, and work through that funky little maze, and come out on the other end like unfazed, in the sense, and, you know, without hurting anyone's feelings, understanding that people go through things, and you weren't going to allow their low vibrations to come in and, you know, affect you. That's when you've passed another level and you ascended, and you keep going through these levels. So however the case, you're definitely going through some growth. Okay, so here you have a college graduate. That's growth. Okay, spiritual, I don't know too much about spiritual, depending on, I guess, maybe what you're learning too, I don't know. But however the case, let's continue. Don't judge a book by its cover. You don't know who anyone is. I mean, seriously, they could be walking around like they don't have anything, and they're like the smartest person like out there, you know. So too blessed to be stressed. You understand that life is a challenge, and you're not gonna allow anyone to come in, like I said, and push your buttons. God is good all the time. Yes, he is, even in those difficult moments of life. Third party, so maybe there is someone that is dealing with someone who maybe has like a karmic
attached to them. Not too much that they're maybe with them, because, you know, I can't see someone that has elevated to certain degrees wanting to be a third wheel. Okay, or you know what I'm saying? Like, so anyway, karmic family around. So, you know, like I just said, you're gonna have these challenges. So, karmic family, third party karmic attachments, so on and so forth, to a divine masculine. Take heed of your dreams. Okay. Second chance? Maybe. Some place to be. Alright. Name starts with the letter A. Customer service rep. He or she may be a little shy about their emotions or their past. I know this one's really like faint. Excuse me. Someone's name starts with the letter K. This was the card I was saying that came out yesterday. Don't miss that opportunity. There's going to be something else that comes along your way that's going to push you and help you flourish even more. Someone's name starts with the letter D. So we have a D, a K, and an A. Okay, the mask is still on. Someone is not able to step outside of a realm of this existence, you know. That's just not like real, you know, like, or maybe it's something to do with this third party. Like, they don't know how to open up because there's still things attached to them. So they're just not real. They're just not who you need them to be. They're not open. They're not, I don't know, maybe you need to be, amenable to situations like that. Okay, time to celebrate. Congratulations. Maybe you've learned how to get over this person that has a third party attachment to them, and maybe someone else is gonna introduce themselves, you know. And I'm not too sure. You have here the word Honda, car. Maybe someone drives a Honda. The letter P. So P, K, D, and A. Your energy levels are incredibly high. So, you know, watch the third parties and the karmic families. I'm telling you, trying to bring you down, especially as you're trying to get higher. That's the devil's job, to hold you down so you don't rise, okay? So here, love's R&B music. Keep your vision. Don't let anybody come in and mess with that. Alright, question it. I'm just saying, be sure. And get ready. It's on the way. Awesome. So, I'm gonna take here the Guardian of the Night Tarot deck again, because it's late night. It's 11:50 now as I'm getting ready to start. So I appreciate you guys for being here with me. If you're still here with me, I appreciate you and I thank you. And let's see what we get, okay? So yes, you are really ascending and getting over challenging times and moments in your life, and ascending to new levels and new heights and new frequencies and all those things, and really grabbing a hold of who you are and what you want to achieve and how you want to achieve it. And so there are so many great things for you that are on the way because you and your frequency has changed. You no longer reside in the lower realm, the lower frequency of things. And I'm going to get a bottom of the deck card, and then after that I'm going to proceed and see what three cards come out, and then we'll keep moving. So yeah, the time just flew past me. Like, for it to already be almost 12 o'clock, it's like, what the heck is going on? I didn't even work that late. I guess when I came home, I went straight outside to deal with my animals before it got really late. And, you know, all the housework and chores, cleaning up my house and showering and reading. And, like, dang. I'm glad I didn't fall asleep, though, because if I would have fallen asleep and woke up, it would have been a new day. So I don't mind it going into a new day, but I wanted to actually get it while the time was within the date of the 4th. So, however the case. Alright, here we go. The bottom of the deck, I have a card here, and the card is hold on, guys. 1 second. This day is gonna be wonderful. There you go. A Two of Pentacles situation. And anytime I get Two of Pentacles, I say that you are looking at your past, your present, and what you want your future to be. So, and just like that song, you say today is gonna be wonderful. It's gonna be wonderful. You don't have not an ache or a pain or anything bad. You're vibing high. You're saying this day is gonna be wonderful. Literally. And this day is gonna be wonderful. I said it. She said, I said it. Okay? That's what's up. Yes, your day is gonna be wonderful. And may every day be wonderful. You know, you have to speak it into existence. And don't let a damn person come in and take your joy, take your foundation of happiness and celebration away from you. You're happy, okay? You're celebrating. I mean, you have college graduation out there. Maybe you're getting ready to graduate college, okay? 4 of Wands doesn't always have to mean marriage, family, and foundation. It can just mean a celebration or a foundation, okay? 5 of Wands. You had this card 2 days in a row. But, one was at the bottom of the deck when we first started. Excuse me. I don't remember. I think the other one actually came out in the read. But I'm going to move this down, guys. So, like I said, you don't have not a hurt, ache. You're happy about the foundation that you are setting up for yourself, or there's some sort of celebration coming.
And there's just people in your way. It's just people in your way. Just period. Beaver's like, damn, can I make me a freaking space to live? I mean, geez, I need these ones, but like, you're in my way. Oh wow, Ten of Pentacles. Prosperity. Divine masculine. So there's a divine feminine that you want to have this Ten of Pentacles with. But it seems like no matter how many relationships you've tried to plant your seeds in, nothing has come about out of that. And maybe you're a little perturbed about that. But you know that, you know, like, no one can resist how bright you are, and so the wheel of fortune will be basically your prosperity. You know, the sun will shine, you will continue to get great things that will come towards you, and you're not worried about it because you don't give up on yourself. You have a lot of strength regardless of the things that have happened, the things that people say, how people may be in the way, you know, all their nonsense comments. And you know how to walk away from things. You know how to turn your back, like, I don't have time to hear any of that. You know, you want to be negative over here, I gotta go over there. I didn't really ask for your opinion or your suggestion at that moment, you know. I'll ask for it when I ask for it, you know. So here you have the Judgment. And your judgment is you being prosperous and having prosperity because you know how to walk away. Yeah, so as things are moving for you, okay, and changing, you're once again realizing that no one can come and take this shine away from you. You had the sun and the star the other day. Literally, the sun was at the bottom of the deck, okay? And the star came out like twice with the Seer's deck, I believe. You are, you are bright and you really see that now. And there is nothing that anyone can do to you. So you're going to get everything that you deserve and some because of how courageous you are, how strong you are. Look at there. You're on top of your game. King of Pentacles? You're like, yeah, baby. It's all there. You know, so whoever didn't want to work with me before, they're bad. I'm not going chasing anybody. I'm not doing any of those things. This was in a struggle. And so I want to take it just like this. Because it came out more like this than like this. So there's nothing in your mind that you're doubting. And that's why you're getting all these great things. Because you're not doubting who you are. You're not doubting your movements. You're not doubting anything. You understand that all the flexibility, okay, that you have done, all the suggestions that you have taken, man, you are
like, you're already, like, right there. You're the King of Pentacles. You're literally just waiting for the right person to come in and make your life complete so you can have a whole family. That's what you want. Now you want the whole package. You know, like, it's cool to be a bachelor or a bachelorette. But the reality is there is a sector called love and we all want it. It's good to be able to, excuse me guys, enjoy self and then have all that self-love and all those things and be able to be happy in one's own space and all that. But realistically speaking, we all want to be in a real genuine loving relationship. You know, and yes, they are hard to find. Yes, they are hard to come by. Sometimes you may have to sacrifice or be flexible a little bit. And those are things that you have to sacrifice, you know, your time by yourself, sharing your bed, all these different things, if that's what you want. And, you know, you want this loving relationship, you know, maybe a couple of things you have to sacrifice or be really flexible about. But, you know, if you're this King of Pentacles and you, the Ten of Pentacles came out and the Four of Wands, like I said, it doesn't have to be a marriage, but I think that is something or some sort of foundation that you would like. So, however the case, I mean, Three of Pentacles talks about working with people, you know, to build. I mean, it could be people that you work with. You know, it could be. But, I think I want to use these. I was looking over here at the door, the sun, and the divine deck, but I think I want to use these next. We're talking about a divine masculine. Not saying that I couldn't have used that divine deck here, but I want to use these, I think. So, you are just, I was about to say, like, you, like, feeling yourself, but not, like, in a bad way, you know, like, you're just, you're really sitting in a good space right now. You've done the work, and, nobody can pull you off of your throne, like, literally, for real, nobody, nobody but God. God is good all the time, and he got you through, and, you know that the sun shines, and you understand, you know, the powers of the sun outside, and the sun of God. You understand the powers, and where everything comes from, and how you got yours, just like the read yesterday, or the day before. So, yeah, you're like, I am really... You're really feeling like you have reached a point where, like, there is no turning back. That's, like, never happening. And you're ready to, complete this cycle. You have the Wheel of Fortune, too. So you're ready to lay down some new, like, bricks for your bath or something. Like, you want to try something different, you know? Or dig a new path or something. You want to try something new. And maybe you're trying to get suggestions on how to, incorporate or to like make this next move with like all the money that you make. Like maybe you're asking someone else that has a lot of money or something like that. Like, you know, does it work? You know, did you like get a prenup or, you know, like you really, you know, like I don't know. Like, I don't know what's going on here, what I'm feeling right now, but somebody has like a lot of money and you've been through so much and there's no hurt or anything that you're going through at this time. Like, you're like living fancy free. You've been a bachelor for a while and you really enjoy your bachelor life. But there are times when you feel like, I guess, not necessarily lonely, but like, you know, like you just wish that there was someone in particular to shine with you, you know. Like, I guess maybe you're getting older or something like that. But you don't doubt, like, or question where you are. You're very satisfied with how you live and all those things. And I don't know if maybe you're afraid to work with someone, or you're trying to find out some information about, I don't think it's you trying to find information about a person. I just think that maybe it's just like, I think you have like a lot of money or something and you're just like, well, if I get married, you know, like, or start dating, you know, what if they only love me for my money? You know, maybe I should get a prenup. Like I said, I don't know why prenup and you know, all this stuff. I guess because of marriage. And then that amenable word came up. And I'm like, what? Taking suggestions from who and for what? When you've gotten to this level, or was it just because, or was it because, no, I'm not wanting to use the word because, or was it the suggestions that you have already taken to get you to this point? But your judgment here is because you understand exactly who you are, and you took the bull by, look at the sun again. So you took the bull by the horns and you accomplished so much. And I guess you were maybe afraid once upon a time to work with someone. You know, like, can I work with you? Like, you know, will you like play me or try to, you know, take all my money? You know what I'm saying? Like, what is up? You have the mask is still on too, so I don't know if you're dating someone and you can't like, you can't either, something you feel like something is they're not sharing or showing or something. This is interesting. This is the second deck, you guys. I appreciate you if you're still here with me. All right, let's get a card for the bottom. I'm definitely going to sleep. I was going to do another read for the other channel, but please, maybe tomorrow. I try to still do the love reads over there for the zodiac signs, but I'm tired. My mind is on tonight. I'm like thinking about all who knows how many different things. Okay. So, here we go. What? Okay. this deck ain't messing with me. The devil. So maybe you're just like, yeah, maybe you're feeling some sort of, like, maybe you're dating one person in particular, and that you like, I don't know, like, you felt something weird about them, or maybe you ran a background check on them or something. I don't know what this is about. This is crazy. I don't know what's going on here with this feeling that I have about this Ten of Pentacles and this amenable. So here you have the Magician, right? The Medicine Man. So, like, you feel like you can excuse me, make anything work or make anything happen. Excuse me, guys. This is an interesting read. So here you have the Four of Swords, and it says contemplation. Falling here on top of Judgment, Ten of Pentacles, King of Pentacles, Three of Swords in reverse, and Seven of Pentacles. So you're in this contemplation state, protecting your heart because you don't have any pain anymore. That's over, that's done. You're not allowing people to hurt you, but at the same time, you're very protective of yourself, and you're like, I can't just let this person in. You know, I question every single little thing, you know, especially with the status where I'm at. You know, I'm not even sure if I'm reading these people right, you know. So, maybe you're, like I said, maybe you're asking for suggestions. Like, should I do background checks on these people? Oh, God, it's funny. Here you go. Ace of Pentacles. That's a big horn. You know, you're going to eat a long time. So, you make the money. So, it's some sort of, maybe also something new, right? Like, don't miss this opportunity. There's going to be another business venture or something else that's coming in for you. It's going to be big. And you're going to do great in it. Okay. The Moon. You may not be talking about this business venture to anyone, you know. Just keeping it to yourself, which is the best thing to do. Never talk about your ideas and things to people. They kill your dreams. They kill everything. So, tell them after the fact, and they can either be happy for you or hate on you or whatever. So here you have the Six of Swords. Oh no, I'm sorry. Six of Wands. So, whatever it is, like, hey, you have the Judgment here too. Okay. You have the Ten of Pentacles. It's falling here, and you will have something that's worth something eventually, okay? Here. Excuse me. That's the Nine of Swords. So, you've in a hurry. So, you've been through things, you know, in your past, and you just really don't want to go through that anymore, you know, and especially because of where you are and all the different things that you've seen. And you're very wise, very, and you're just like, I don't want not a one more feather plucked off of me. I'm not too excited when that happens. So please don't come and do anything to me that I don't want done. And I'm trying to see what I see in you, and something's telling me that you may try to pluck one of my feathers. So I'm very second. Is this the Wheel of Fortune? Oh, this is the World. Oh, okay. Wait, what? Oh, okay. So you have the Wheel of Fortune. Yesterday you had the Wheel of Fortune and the World too. They were both in reverse. I think that was yesterday's read. Right, yeah. So today you have the Wheel of Fortune and the World. This is the World card. Interesting. Seems like the Wheel of Fortune, but I'm gonna let that go. It says 21 at the bottom, and that's the World card. So he just said the world is mine, so please. So, it's just like, the world is yours, you know, and it's yours because you understand who you are. You understand, you listen to the assignments that are given to you by God. He said, I take what's mine and take some more. And I was about to say, you take in what's given to you, you know. So, the energy is here, okay. Yes, the energy is here, and you know, so the world is yours, and you will be victorious. You will have someone, and maybe you do need to run background systems, background checks. I said test background checks on certain people, you know. So I don't know. Oh my God. Mother of Earth is a pentacle. So that's who you're looking for. You're the King of Pentacles. You're looking for someone literally that's like you, that's boss material, that's on your level. Interesting. This is an interesting read, but I mean, kind of, but not really, you know. Like, it's, I'm really getting like all this energy of like, dang, all these songs are popping too. She said, we just keep on going. Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, I just feel this energy that's like nonstop for a lot of you. Like, you guys are nonstop. Like, there's some energy, and there's like, you guys are like real forces out there. Like, please, like, I'm on top of my game. Like, there's nothing or nobody, the world, society, like, I don't know what y'all got going on, but I'm over here doing this. I'm doing me. I'm doing great. Like, you know, yeah, wow, amazing. So I appreciate you guys if you're still here with me. 53:50 on the timer. This is the third deck. I appreciate you guys for being here with me so very much. I appreciate your time and your energy and your support. So I appreciate you. And come back and rock with your girl anytime here on Ophiuchus and Me. I'm always here doing daily reads for you. Like, share, comment, and subscribe, please, and thank you. And of course, only if you like. I appreciate it all. Thank you once again, and let's get it with this third deck and see what comes out. The world is yours. Literally. And you've been mad flexible. Taking in all these different aspects of things and trying your best to really like pinpoint and direct yourself and your energy in the right places, and not overdo it and not under feel or think or, you know, any of those things. You're trying to really stay on point here. But you know, there's so much changing and going on for you and coming in for you. So yeah, sheesh, stay strong. For the bottom of the deck, let's see what we get. It's time for me to go to bed, y'all. It's 12:22 on the clock. It's time for me to go to bed. Alright. Oh, the bottom of the deck I have for you all. Excuse me. Ten of Wands. You had that card yesterday. It's about you putting down negativity. And taking the biggest leap that you could possibly take, which is on yourself. And here it's coming up in the normal position, and this first time I had it, I took it in reverse, saying that you're not in any type of doubt with who you are, where you're going, or anything like that, but you took a leap, made a major leap on yourself, and you've been going, and at first maybe you didn't know what was going to happen, how things were going to happen, all these things. I see there's a little child in the background. Maybe you never thought that any of those things would happen, and you doubted yourself because of your background, where you came from, how long it took for you to get to like the level where you are now. But when you took that first initial leap on yourself, maybe it was you going to college, you know, maybe your parents used to argue about things, and you know, didn't have enough money, couldn't send you to college, and you sent yourself to college. And here's Seven of Pentacles. You sent yourself to college. You didn't think that things would ever happen for you, especially after you tried so many different times on a lot of different projects or relationships or whatever you tried to get to grow, and things just didn't take root right away. Well, why do you think they didn't take root right away? Because this energy wants to keep you stuck all the time. It never fails. Okay? He wants to keep you stuck. and have you not elevate to the highest level, because you are that bright. You are the sun and the star, okay? And you know how bright you are, and especially now, there's nothing that can ever hold you back. There's no turning back, like I said. You're never going back that way. And he has no power over you. There's no way in hell that he's going to pull you down to hell, okay? You're just keeping your movement forward because you're super strong. You don't have any time to get involved with the low frequencies. They want you to play, but you're like, please, get out of here. So, I appreciate you guys for being here with me. I'll be back again tomorrow. You guys have a good night, or a good day, or good morning, or wherever you are, whatever time you see this. And you guys be good out there. Take care, guys. Have a good one. Bye-bye.